Hello everyone, welcome back to the second part of easy-pil tutorial. So in this tutorial we will create something real that can be used in your website or your Discord bot or whatever you want. So we'll just today create something for a Discord bot. Like in the previous video I shown you this ranker, Arcane bot's ranker. So we will just recreate this using easy-pil, so you get the idea of combining everything into something real. Let's start it. First of all, you have to install the latest version of easy-pil. Actually it's version 3.0.0.3, so we can just pass that also. You can see 0.0.3 has been installed, but when the time you are watching this, there may be a different version out. You can check it by searching like this, and you can go here. And you can see the current updated version is 0.0.3, so you have to always install the latest version to make it work. Okay, so first of all we have to see that we have a background, but for background we will use this image. We will not use a just a color, but let's use this image. So first of all, let's create the background. Let's import things that we need. For now we just need the editor. So editor, and we have to pass the image path we want to use, the PNG. So it's in the assets folder, so we have to just pass the folder name, then bg.png. We have initialized the background in our editor, so we have the background in our background. Next, let's see what is here. Let's create this bar here, the thing here. So let's create a canvas. So we name it the what we name it. Let's name it a square. So to create a square, let's import canvas and give it a width and height. So if this bg.png has a width of 900 pixel and height of 300 pixels, if you want to check your image dimension, let's choose an image. We'll choose the current image. So this is the current image. If we go to properties and details, you can see it's 900 pixel width and 300 pixel height. So let's create an square with a 300 pixel by 300 pixels, and also then edit this one. So and then we have to pass the canvas is equals to a square, then a square dot rotate. How many degrees we want to rotate? If you see, this might be 45 degrees. And then let's just background or paste square dot image. Okay, so we are pasting this square in our background. Let's now see the background, how it is looking. So Python. A paste is actually requiring a position where we want to paste it, let's say 600 and 0. So yeah, in canvas also we need a color. Let's put a color red. What is that? Paste image and then position. Oh yes, sorry. I have to pass the image first, then position. Okay, we have pasted it here, but it's not looking good, but we will just make it, no problems. Let's do it 700 and see if we get the result. Okay. One more thing, when rotate, you can just pass expand is equals to true, so it don't crop it while rotating it. Okay, we are getting the result, but in backwards, so maybe minus 200. Let's see where it goes. Okay, so we just need a slightly less. Let me see first of all what is here. Okay, what am I doing? So the canvas give it a more width, like 500 pixels minus 200. Let's put 300 and see. Yeah, so we need a less rotation, 45, maybe 30. Then push it down a little bit to minus 300, minus 200. Okay, so let's make the height bigger, 500. Okay, let's bring it up, minus 250. These calculations are actually a bit hard, so you have to play around with the values to make it exactly like this or whatever you want. Maybe 600 here. So you can see we got similar results here. Okay, so it took us some time to know what are the values. You will also have to play around with the values, so you can get the most accurate result. So we have pasted the what is that, is like the square. Okay, so you might want a different color. For that you can use hex color codes. Let me see. HTML color codes, and you can just get whatever color you want here. Let's see what's our image color. If you see, maybe we want something similar to this color. So if you just play with this and this color and then copy this and just paste it here, let me see what color we got. Okay, this is actually looking good for me, but you can use any color. Okay, next is, what is next? We have the profile picture here. So for the profile picture, let's then get the profile picture like pfp.png, and as it is in the assets folder, so we pass that also. And then we have to resize the image because we don't want it to be that long. it's very big according to the PG. So we have a height of 300, and if we want something here, so maybe that is 200 by 200 pixels. Let me see. So resize it 200 by 200 and paste the profile dot ms and this 50 50. Oh yeah, so my stereotyping mistake. You can see we pasted it here, but it's still so big. We need more or less maybe 100 by 100. Let's see. Maybe a little bigger, so 150 might be good. I think so, and also maybe 30 by 30, the paste position, okay. And then just make the MS circle here. Okay, so we got similar results as the reference image here. Yeah, next is the horizontal progress bar. You can see here. Let us create that also. We have to create a rectangle and its position. If we now see the current image, we want this to be here, so that is something. 30 by maybe 200. Its width will be let's say 700 pixels and height will be 30 pixels. Color, not color, it's fill. Fill color will be white, and I think that's it. Let's see what we got. We got it, but maybe we want more height, push it a little down, and less width. So let's, width is equals to, let's say 650. The height will be 40 and maybe 220. Okay, looking good. Let's see the reference here and let's see this one. Yes, very similar. Now we want a radius to be 20. Let's see again. Yeah, so we got a better result. Now inside the rectangle we will have a progress bar according to what percentage. So that will be a bar. Instead of width, we will have a max width. Height is alright. The fill color will be different. So let's grab a different color. Maybe this color here. Let's just copy this color. That's it. And also the percentage, how many percentage we want to move it, like 30%. You can see this is actually working great. What's next? We have this account name, then a line, and then some extra text. So let's do that. We need a text first. So in the background, then text, we have position. Let's say we want to move it here, like maybe 200 pixels. And then from top, maybe 30 pixels. Then we want the text. Let's put my name. Okay. Then we can also pass a font, and if you want to create your, we just downloaded a font in the previous video like this palette, but we will use any default font. Let's use the Poppins font. For that we have to import font. If you don't know how to use font, you must watch the previous video. Okay, so you can just say font is equals to font and color is equals to, let's say, white. If we now see this one, okay, actually not font, it's not font, it's Poppins. You can see. We maybe need a little bigger font, 40, if that's good. Okay, that's good. Let's push it a little lower. For that, let's put 40. Okay, that's in right position. Then we want another rectangle, but not in the position of the previous. We'll just use this, and instead of 40, let's say 50. Then width will be like, let's see how much width the image have. If from this, so that might be 650, but maybe 500, and let's say height is equals to 3. Fill width, let's put no radius. Okay, that's a little big. Let's put 300 and see. Yes, that's okay, but let's put 350 and also see. Yeah, that's perfect. Maybe 80 is also not enough. Let's try 100. Yeah, that's good. Maybe the height is little bit more, so let's do. Okay, that's great. Then we might don't want that color. Let's use another color from here. Let's use this color. You can see we got another good result. Next is what we have is this text, and this text is slightly smaller than this, so we have to create another font. Let's use this Poppins, but with a 30 pixel font size. Okay, so we'll just use this and this, and so you cannot rename it same, so you can just make it Poppins small. And here what we have, let's see, level and XP. Okay, so level 1 on 3, then 2 or 3 spaces, then XP, then 10k out of maybe 10k. These are some dummy data. You can use your own. This has 100, so maybe 130. Okay, this is looking good, but the font is bigger. We need more smaller font. 20. Oh yes, we didn't pass the font size here. Well, that's very small. Yeah, so this is looking good. So if we compare this with this, we got very similar result. That's actually it. So we just saw how can we use this easy-pil library to create rank cards. Now if you want to use this inside a bot, you can. So for that, let me just copy the whole thing from PF, from font to end. Okay, we'll use this profile and background later. So I have already a bot created. I will just open that bot. If you don't know what this bot came from, so you can check the link in the description. I have a GitHub repository of this bot which you can just use. So you can see we have a rank command here. Inside of rank command, we will remove everything. We have user data. If you don't know what user data is, you can check the videos. Okay, we will now just do a comment for paste it here. Okay, for the background, we don't have that here, so we have to use a link for the background image, or you can also load local background images. Let me just copy the background image from this to maybe this here. Let's create a folder inside our bot. Okay, so we copied that in assets. So in leveling, background will be editor, then what we have to do is let's just put asset slash, let's make this thing comment out. Okay, so we have the background, and also the important thing is we can also load image async. We can also import load image async from pil, so we can load image from a link. Let me show you. If you want the profile, so await load image async, and then you can pass the link. So str of ctx.author.url. Okay, then we can also use that profile is equals to editor, and we have to pass the profile here. Then we have to resize it. Let me what resize we used, this one. So let's just copy this and paste it here. So now we have the profile and background. Next is the name. In place of name, you can just use str of ctx.author, and for the level and XP, we have this user data. So I have something maybe here, user data XP and user data XP. We can just copy the whole thing from here, and then okay, and for the level, this thing will come from your database, so you have to create your database according to what kind of data you are using. Next is we have level XP. Okay, for the bar actually. For the bar, how many percentage we have gone? So for that we have to do some calculations. Let me remove these things. Okay, let's create also a file. Okay, that's it. So in the bar we have to pass this percentage, how many percentage the user has gone. So for that we have to do some calculations. Okay, so in user data, if we have, like, let me show you first. If we have 100 XPs and to go in the next XP we need 200, so let's say we have, and the current level XP is 100, and let's say you have 150, that means if the current level XP is 100, we need to go to 200 to go next level. And if we have 150, then how many percentage we have gone? Okay, so to calculate this percentage, we have to, like, next level XP divided by 100. Actually this calculation is getting complicated. Let me just pause the video and see how can I do that. Okay, so I just did many calculations and came with this. So we have to get the next level XP. So what will be the XP to reach next level, and what is the current level minimum XP here? And then we are just calculating how many XP we need to bypass the current level, so next level XP and current level XP. Then how many XP user have, if we see the current level XP minus users XP, so that's the XP have. Then XP need divided by 100 into XP have, and we will get the percentage out of 100. And then that, for that percentage we are just passing it here. And now we have successfully made this inside this rank command. If we now run the bot, let's hope that this will work. Let me open Discord. Okay, so if we do like rank, we should not see any kind of error. Yeah, we got an out. That's a typo. Okay. So that is not something that we want. Leveling slash asset slash, maybe this will work. Let's stop the bot and see why this is not stopping. Okay, no errors, and you can see we got something, but yeah, the bar is not right, so we can see level is something weird. Okay, what has done here? Oh, we can just pass like XP and okay, let's restart and see. Okay, level 2 and XP 235 out of 300, and this bar is not looking good. What's the issue here? The bar has an height of 30 and the percentage is, oh, maybe that's the calculation error. Let's print percentage and see how many percentage we got. Oh, that is minus 40. How can it be minus 40? Current level XP. Oh yeah, user XP minus current level XP. That should look good. Yeah, so you can see we have 245 out of 300, and that is like here. If we type some messages to gain some XP, and if we see rank again, you can see we have 295, and that's very close. So if we type one message and see rank again, you can see we have reached level 3 and XP 305, and we're at the beginning. So you can see now that this is working, and we created a rank card using easy-pil and integrated it into this bot. And for the coding of this bot, if you don't know how I coded this bot, you can watch that video. I have also that uploaded on my YouTube channel, so check that out. And if you don't want to check, you can just download the codes, so you can just use it along this tutorial. So thank you so much for watching. Let's see you in the next video, and also if you have any questions, you can comment that. I will try my best to help you. Also, you can join my Discord server. If you have any questions, I can also answer there. See you in the next video.